What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to the Illinois Tech Dynasty as we get set for another big conference showdown on the road. It's time for Week 11 and another meeting with the SMU Mustangs. After last week's win on the road, the Wolfpack have climbed to number 4 in the nation, but we did not like what we saw from the defense against Houston. It was a very back-and-forth game with the scoring, giving up 31 points, a season high. And despite their record, SMU's got a pretty good roster that could do the same if this defense isn't up to par this week. We'll see the defense after the offense takes the field here as Greg Reyes takes a knee to begin the ball game. Illinois Tech from their 25, and Kevin Fields stepped up to the plate last week. 3 touchdowns against a very good Houston defense. SMU secondary also pretty talented. We'll see what they do here to get the ball game going. It's Andre Hafer left side and picking up where he left off last week. Nice little 10-yard run to get the ball game going and could very well cross 1,000 on the year this game. Here's Hayford again on second down right side. This time an easy 5-yard run. Good start for the offense. Here's Fields on first and 10. Has time underneath. Eric Chirillo's first catch of the ball game. And quickly moving upfield for a first down. There's 12. Didn't have the huge game last week, but that doesn't mean you can leave him uncovered. Second and 5. A split back look for the offense. They're going to go to McLaughlin, who gets planted and ends up losing one. Michael Clark, their star safety. Big hit there, forcing 3rd and 6. Here's Trios in motion on 3rd down, Fields to the air. Looking for something downfield, no one open, buys time, runs right, throws on the move, hits O'Brien, but he can't get a foot down near the sideline. That's going to lead to a 4th down punt, and out comes Corey Perkins. Good start for the Houston defense as Perkins punt sent down range, and it goes off the side of his foot, and that's barely going 15, maybe 20 yards. Must be the rust because we don't see much of Perkins. 1st and 10, good field position for the Mustangs to get things going. Here's Russell Brady throwing on the move and a one-handed snag by Myron Galliard. We're about to watch 2 of the top receivers in the conference this ball game. Obviously, Chirillo's for the Wolfpack, who leads this conference in yards and touchdowns, and Galliard, who is a big-time target for this offense and obviously caused issues for this defense last year. After moving the chains, here's Brady rolling out again left side. This is going to be incomplete. Not sure if that was a forward pass. Should have been a fumble. 2nd down from midfield, Russell Brady with time out to the flat. Here's Thomas with the grab and the big body Alfonso. Thomas picks up 5. He's very difficult to bring down. 3rd and 5 now for SMU. Going screen left side. Thomas with the grab. Gets away from Hicks but runs out of bounds. And they end up losing 3, so they're forced to punt. So this ball game still tied at nothing. Here's Fields to the air to begin this drive. And a quick throw right side to Brent Brown. Good for 7. Brown's had up and down games this year, sometimes very involved, other times not very. Here's Hayford, nice little sweep left side, picks up 7, and the Wolfpack do move the chains. Hopefully they can find a way to keep this going. Empty look on 1st and 10, everyone in tight. Field has time, taking a shot deep downfield for Chris King, and not necessarily getting the separation needed. Good coverage by Desmond Fox. King just doesn't have that speed. Here's a bunch left on 2nd down. Fields to throw once again. Runs right the buy time. Hits Brent Brown. He got across midfield. The spin move gets him even more yardage. And he's inside SMU territory to their 22. There's 45 yards. And I think Fields, if he waited a second or two, absolutely had a touchdown for Chirillo as the corner, for whatever reason, peeled off him to take away Brent Brown. And that was a big missed opportunity. 1st down and 10. Here's Andre Hayford to get them down to around the 20. Average just under 6 yards a carry. Here's 2nd down and 9. Again, they go to the ground. Andre Hayford left side. Lowers the shoulder. Runs through the safety. Picks up 9. 3rd and 1 now for the offense. What do the Wolfpack do here on 3rd down? They're going to go right back to their ground game. And they nearly got a stop there. David James, the center, lost that matchup, but Hayford with the muscle picks up a tough earned 2 yards. Offense inside the 15-yard line now. Here's Fields rolling out to buy time again, and there's no one open. Good pass rush, good coverage. Fields is forced to throw that away. Here's 3rd down and 9. Hayford stays in the block. Fields with time looking for something. No one open, decides to run. Gets the offense inside the 5 to around the 2, maybe the 3, but they're going to take their 3 points here. Very low scoring first quarter. You got to get something on the board here. And indeed, the Wolfpack do. Zach Carroll, good. Some big games going on around the conference this week. And Cincinnati is really blowing what little chance they had to reach a conference championship. That East Division is a complete mess right now. And obviously the Wolfpack looking to wrap up the West with a big win this week. And a keeper here for Russell Brady is going to pick up a Mustangs first down. Full Joe Washington got 10 yards. Nice play. Here's another option. Brady left side, able to get away from McKenzie Walker there to wrap him up from behind and keep him at a two this time. That'll take this ball game to the second quarter. Brady to the air to get this quarter going. Pass out in time as he gets slammed by Jason Hicks. But the pass complete to John Alexander for 20. Talk about standing in the pocket and delivering a throw. What a play there by Russell. Here's Thomas getting away from two defenders, and it takes four to bring him down 8-yard run. Tackling was an issue last week. It continues to be an issue here in week 11. Here's Thomas on second down. Gets away from Cobbs and finds a lane. He's in the clear. He's gone. Touchdown SMU. 35-yard run, and this run defense off to another shaky start. This is not good. Only one defender touched Thomas. It was Cobbs, who immediately got stiff-armed. And there's no linebackers. There's no corners. There's no defensive linemen. They got even close. That was not very good. Defense is going to have to find a way to rebound on their next drive, but the offense has got to find a way to find a touchdown this drive. These defensive backs for SMU are really taking away these receivers, and they've got to find a way to work around them as Hayford gets this drive going with 10. First down and 10. Fields again rolling out right side. Stops, throws, has a man again. Brent Brown getting separation, 14 yards this time. Already a great average for Brown. That's 22 yards a catch. Second down for the offense across midfield. Kevin Fields looking down the field and wide open all alone. Marcus O'Brien, 47-yard touchdown. That's miscue number two for this Mustang secondary. This time, Kevin Fields doesn't miss it. And it's a 10-7 lead. Hopefully, the defense doesn't give it right back. Brady from the pistol hands off once again. Right side, Afonso Thomas. This time, kept to one. Good tackle there by Tremaine Vinson. As we get to see a little bit of 4-3 defense. Quickly back to their 4-2-5 look. Brady has time, taking a shot deep left sideline. Ball jumped and intercepted. Sean Hollins, third pick of the season. And a lot of them coming in this very short stretch of games. Great coverage on Marty Galliard. Jump ball that Galliard had no chance to get. And that's a big time takeaway that should hopefully allow this offense to increase their lead. Sometimes you want to make the big play down the field, but you can't make the mistake of giving this offense good field position. Fields throwing on first and 10, finds O'Brien underneath the coverage and a little spin there. Looks like he got a little turnaround there. There's eight. Second down and two for the offense. Kevin Fields from the gun. Here's an option, and Fields is not going anywhere. Good defense by this front line for SMU. Third down and two. Illinois Tech, here's Fields under center. Hands off. Hayford finds a lane. First down run. That'll get them across midfield. There's another nine. Hayford's run game pacing pretty well. First and 10. Back across midfield. A quick throw here to Reels with the spin move and made that defender hit the ground. Someone get that guy a life alert. There's another first down for Torrios. 18-yard gain gets him down to around the 30. Here's Fields on first down. Play fake and no one's open. He'll take off the run again. Made the right decision. Here's another first down play. That time a 10-yard scramble. Offense moving the ball pretty well now. A two tight end look. Here's Fields looking, running right to buy time again. And this time going down. Kevin Fields sacked by Michael Clark. 3rd and 19, a play later. Got to find a way to convert here. Fields running left, throwing on the move underneath. There's Brown with the catch, but not even close to a first. Gain of two, and out comes Zach Carroll. Bit of a long one, but the win at his back. 43-yarder from the left hash. Sanchez, good hole. Carroll's kick on the way, and it is good. 13-7 the score. Illinois Tech's defense set to retake the field, and a two-minute drill upcoming for the Mustangs. Three timeouts to work with, and this is where you will like to see this Wolfpack defense step up and get another stop. And there's a big play there, big hit by Ricky Hodges, forcing second down. Russell Brady from the pistol. Galliard so far only that one reception. Here's a throw downfield from Brady that's nearly intercepted by Jack Cobbs. Would have been his second this season. And that'll force third down. Still 10 yards to go. Tight end in motion. Here's Brady. Illinois Tech rushing six. Brady's pass off in time, but nearly intercepted again by Sean Holland, who's had Galliard on shutdown alert when he's covering him. Last time it was zone for the pick. This time man coverage. That's great coverage on the wheel. And with a minute 30 to go, there's still time for this offense to make a few plays. 13-7 the score now. Here comes Greg Reyes redirecting. Nice little loop there to get to the right side of the field. And Reyes across midfield. Beautiful return, 30 yards. So the ball across midfield, minute 20 to go with three timeouts. This could be trouble if this defense can't get a stop. And here's O'Brien on the mid-screen left side. That's well covered. SMU's covering all the short stuff really well. It's just the stuff down the field that they're not having fun with. Fields could have maybe gone to Edwards, the tight end. Instead, he runs on second down. He's got space, and this is going to lead to a six-yard scramble as he stepped out of bounds on accident. Third down, Hayford carries. This one should be good for the first. They're going to rule it short, and you're going to see Coach Chris Hall quickly throw that red flag. Hayford, there's no way this wasn't a first down. The defender was on the first down marker. Hayford rolled over him. That should be a first. And indeed, it is overruled. First down and 10, just outside the 30. Clock still ticking. Here's Fields on first and 10, left side. Hayford with the grab, and that's going to lead to a short gain. And there you see the first timeout for the Wolfpack. Trying to take all the time off the clock they can. Here's second and 8, Fields outside. McLaughlin in the flat, absolutely drilled. 6-yard gain, and another timeout called. And field goal range, needing 2 yards with 9 seconds left. Just don't get greedy. Fields on third down will just tuck it and run. Try to get them as close as they can as he gets this one inside the 10 and barely gets the timeout call with a second on the clock. It was risky, but it worked. And here's Carroll's third field goal of the first half right down the middle, 16-7. I'd say this game is going a lot better than last week's. Defense playing a much better overall game. Still a few things to work out, but the offense keeping them in front. Second half coming up next. Week 11 sailing a lot smoother than week 10, that is for sure. The offense has them up 16-7, and the defense outside of that one big run has not really allowed much. Only one turnover so far, should have been maybe two or three, but you look at the way the SMU's offense has moved the ball or has not moved the ball so far. It's been a pretty ugly game on their end. Time of possession, Illinois Tech has nearly as many rushing yards as they have total yards. But of course, there's time to turn things around or maybe make things even worse. And we'll see what SMU decides to do here as they start from their own 25-yard line. Wolfpack defense on the field. 91 yards given up through the first half, but no sacks. This front line has not played great over the past couple of weeks. Here's a give to Thomas right side, and Ricky Hodges meets him before he gets too far. That's a 1 yard loss, actually. First tackle for Hodges this game. Only one catch so far for Galliard. Here's second down. Brady outside. This to the flat and out of bounds. Incomplete. Third down upcoming. Big chance there to get a stop for the defense to start out this third quarter. Here's Russell Brady to the air and taken down. No one open downfield. It's Jamal Walker with another sack on the season. No spin move this time, just a quick move past the guard in the center, and that's pretty much all she wrote. Starting from their own 30-yard line, here's Kevin Fields to the air. O'Brien over the middle, all alone, picks up 10, nearly a first down. SMU's defense being very aggressive, and that's led to a lot of easy completions over the middle. Here's another blitz on second down. Fields gets drilled, and he lost the football, scooped up by the Mustangs. Well, that time the blitz got there. Kevin Fields blindsided from behind. That's going to be a sack fumble for Fox. And maybe next time SMU stacks the box, they won't go play action. Better off there just giving the ball to Hayford, who might have gotten the first down and more with that gap that was right down the seam. Wolfpack defense back out there looking for someone to make a play. Here's a quick throw to the flat for Scott, who's all alone, getting the Mustangs inside the red zone and down to around the 10. There's 19 yards. Uncovered in the flat, gotta make sure someone's over there. First and 10, Brady with time, throws this one to the right out of bounds. Scott was there, but well covered. Coverage to start this half has been impeccable. Here's second down. They'll go to the ground game. Afonso Thomas finds a lane. Ricky Hodges got held up, and that's going to be another touchdown. It's 13-16. And just like that, the Mustangs closed the lead. Hodges had a chance to make a play. Ran into the back of Walker. 2-point ball game here in the third quarter. Got to find a way to make up for the turnover and get this lead back for the offense. Here's Andre Hayford, first down, working right side. And again, this front seven, or front six for the Mustangs, is playing pretty well. Third and four play later. Fields to the air, looking for something downfield. Ball thrown to the flat for Haynes, and that could have and should have been trouble for Fields, who luckily didn't throw his fourth pick of the season, but back to SMU the football goes. A chance for them to get the lead here. This is going to be tipped at the line of scrimmage by Dwyer coming on the blitz. Very similar play to what won the Wolfpack their game last week. Second down for Brady. He's got time, looking for something underneath. Afonso Thomas hit hard by Anderson. He holds on to the football. That's a five-yard pickup. Third and five now for the Mustangs. Can the defense find a stop? Here's Brady. Right side, he's got Becker with the first down grab. Still going across midfield. There's 15 yards. Again, it's the Mustangs getting across midfield. Defense stacks the box on first and 10. They're going to back everyone out. Here's Brady. Got away from Walker. No idea how he did it, but he gets it off in time and finds his man downfield. 42-yard connection for John Alexander, and the offense for SMU is back inside the 10. Here's a first down run. Thomas trips and stumbles for a one-yard gain. Thomas looking for his third score of the ball game, and the Wolfpack will stack the box. Second down, back to Thomas, finding a lane, and that's too easy. Where was Anderson going? He shot the lane, had a clear path at the running back, but completely shot the run. That'll make it a four-point ball game, and SMU wants it to be a six-point lead. Gallier lined up wide left. He's only got one catch so far. Here's Alexander over the middle, who can't hold on. It's Joe Washington with the good coverage, and that's going to keep this at a four-point ball game. Ball goes back to the Wolfpack offense, who have had a really strange stretch of drives. It's not very characteristic of them, but these receivers are having a hard time getting open this half. Here's Fields trying to run. He's been under constant pressure, and luckily they're held on to the football as he got sandwiched between two defenders. He's slow to get up, but he's okay. Third and seven to play later. Offense needs something big here. Fields with time throws. Brent Brown comes through in the clutch. Another catch. That one good for 18. Brown now at 86 yards receiving. Empty look for the offense on first down. Fields with time looking. Taken down again. There's no one open. 9-yard loss taken down by Noah Spears. Last second adjustment by Fields before the snap. Here's second down and 19. Blitz on the way, but Edwards open over the middle. First down, gain of 21. The blitz backfired again. Only the first grab for Edwards. They've got to get him more involved, but more importantly, they need to really take some pressure off this offensive line. They've got to find a way to run the football, and they do just that on first down. The following play, they're 17 yards. Offense back inside the red zone. Second down, Hafer down the middle, runs through the safety and nearly finds a touchdown. There's 18. Knocking on the door as Hafer nears 100 on the ball game, and that does put him over 1,000 on the season. First and goal. Keeper for Kevin Fields. Offense on the board finally with a touchdown. The field goals, they're not going to keep them in front if SMU keeps scoring the way they are. 23-20, though, is the score. And this defense looking for some stops. Here's Russell Brady, first down. Hit as he throws. Ball's off in time. Adrian Lynch, what a catch. But more importantly, what a throw from Brady. Second down, keeper on the option. Brady working left. That's not going to move the chains. Can the defense find a stop on third and inches? Brady, play fake to Thomas, has time, looks over the middle, throws for Lynch, who's got another catch. This time good for 15 yards. They can't hit Galliard. Go to the backup, second best option. Here's a third down to begin the fourth quarter, and a wide open man. Here's Hill outside, getting away from Victor Hicks and picking up another Mustangs first down. They're back inside field goal range. First and 10, Brady still throwing. Here's Hill again. Underneath, 6-yard gain, second down upcoming. This is where this defense needs to make a stand. Hill on second down, gets the football on the ground this time. Lined up in the backfield, picked up another SMU first down. Another red zone trip for the Mustangs. First and 10, Brady on the keeper, tries to make a move on Cobbs, and that's not gonna work. He's going backwards, loss of six. And this defense needs more plays like this against the run. And if Cobbs didn't get through that double team, that could have been 6 points. Third and 12 now for the Mustangs. Here's Brady with time. Pass to the end zone for Lynch. Is caught for a touchdown. 21-yard connection. What was the defense doing? Victor Hicks fell asleep. Perfect throw from Brady. And the Mustangs retake the lead here in the fourth quarter. This game is getting serious. And we need this defense to seriously step up because they are not playing well. There's giving up points to a really good team, and then there's this, which is just a lot of mistakes on defense. Speaking of mistakes, there's another one for the SMU secondary. Edwards gets behind the safety. He's gone. Touchdown. 62 yards, and I'm not sure what happened to the safety that play, but that did not work out at all. It was cover three coverage, and he just let Edwards run right past him, and that's going to be a touchdown. And that's nice for the offense to retake the lead, but this Wolfpack defense out there once again, they have not done much in the second half against his Mustangs offense. Here's Thomas on first down, running up field, and another nice run this time, good for seven. There's still a lot of time left in this ball game, and this is where this defense needs to make a stand. Here's a quick throw from Brady to the flat for Riley, and a six-yard first down. SMU keeps this ball moving. Just seems like they're ready for whatever the Wolfpack are doing on defense. Here's Brady rolling left and throwing the slant to Galliard. Only a second grab of the ball game. I guess that's one win for the defense, and it's mainly been Hollins keeping him contained. Second and 15, Brady outside, Galliard with another catch, and this time it might be trouble. Davis missed a tackle, Cobbs can't get there, neither can Hollins. 54-yard score, and SMU just like that retakes the lead again. Just when you start to compliment this defense, they find a way to mess things up. 5.5 minutes on the clock, and this offense, I think at this point, you've got to be worried about giving the ball back to your defense with too much time more than anything at this point. Obviously, you want to score, but if you score too quickly and give SMU the ball back, we're right back to where we are now, down by 4 points, and obviously we don't need that. So the Wolfpack are going to run the ball back-to-back times. Hafer's got over 100 yards right now. Clock down to around 4.5 minutes. Mustangs bring a blitz. Here's Fields rolling out right side, throwing on the move and finding his man Torrios for a 12-yard first down. That's only his third grab of the ball game. Before that big catch and run for Galliard, both receivers were having pretty rough afternoons. Throwing again on first down, no one open for Fields. He'll run this time and move the chains as he slides at the 45-yard line. Clock now inside of 4 minutes. This is the pacing they need. Now to the ground on second down, and McLaughlin can't get a block from Hayford. Backed up a yard now, third and eight. Wolfpack come out empty. Obviously, this is four down territory. Here's Fields throwing quickly. Slant caught by Torrios. They've got him inside the red zone. The shift in coverage almost got him. Could have been a pick. But instead, the Wolfpack are back in the red zone. 2:26 to go. Here's Fields throwing left on the wheel. That's going to be caught by Hayford for a first down. Could have maybe gone to Brown, and maybe Hayford could have provided a block, but obviously he's not very good at that. Clock down to around 2 minutes. Fields to the end zone. All alone is O'Brien for a touchdown. Second of the ball game. Big drive for Kevin Fields in a three-point ball game. 37-34. What a second half for SMU. They completely flipped the script from that first half performance. And now at least looking to get in the field goal range. Here's a swing pass outside. Thomas got away from Hodges. Picks up around five. And a good rally by the defense. Got to find a way to keep everything in front of you. You cannot let people get behind you this time. Here's Brady, second down, throwing to the outside, and this is Lynch, first down gain of 18. That gets them near midfield with a stopped clock as Davis is just being eaten alive. I mean, it's literally been pitch and catch on that left side of the field all ball game. Another throw from Brady on first down. Good pocket, throwing right sideline. This ball's intercepted by Jamal Dwyer. Minute 37 left, and that could do it. Second pick for the defense, and that's a great time for someone to make a play. Minute 37 on the clock, and this offense needs to burn through three timeouts. Here's Andre Hafer down the middle, and they can't stop him before he picks up 14 yards. Now the Wolfpack offense in the driver's seat. SMU's out of timeouts now. Here's a second down give for Hayford up the middle. They're trying to strip the ball free. Can't get it that time. Gain him nine and a huge third down. Out of field goal range. They're going to the ground game again. This is Hayford with the run and a first down as the ref got a good spot that time. And this ball game is over. Illinois Tech survives a big scare on the road. But still unbeaten 10-0 on the season. And Kevin Fields with another miraculous performance. Three touchdowns, throwing for 339, throwing 80%. Not like SMU's secondary really had a great second half, which is when most of those big plays happen. Andre Hayford, 23 carries, 148, no score this week, unfortunately. And some big play from O'Brien, Brown, and Torrios, and of course the big catch and run for Edwards. Our defense, when you've got your outside corner leading you in tackles, that's an issue. Sean Hollins, 5 on the game. SMU's front line did a great job keeping Brady upright, the only sack coming on that first possession of the third quarter, and of course the two interceptions that were pretty paramount in the outcome of this game. Russell Brady throwing 65% on the ground. Afonso Thomas, only 11 carries on the ball game, 3 touchdowns. I really feel like if they ran the ball more, especially when they were up, I mean, who knows what would have happened, because we couldn't stop Thomas. It was a very rough game, and of course, we did a pretty good job outside of a few plays covering their receivers. Gaylord only 3 grabs on the ball game. Illinois Tech with a big time win. Time of possession, one of the craziest imbalances that we have seen, at least this season. But into week 12 we go. The Wolfpack are 10-0, still number 4 in the nation. And there's one team on our schedule at this point I think could give us trouble. That is the Navy Midshipmen, who we have always had issues defending. And while this team right now is 10-0, 6-0 in conference, 4-0 in division, this conference, or at least the division, is still kind of up for grabs over these next two games. If Navy beats us, and I know it sounds impossible, but with the way our defense is playing right now, especially against the run, I'm concerned. And to be honest, Navy's given us some of the better, more entertaining games in this series. Last season, it went down to a 54-51 overtime win. Obviously, there's the season one matchup with Navy, which went to 8 overtimes, and that game was an absolute doozy. But with the way our defense is playing right now, and the way that Navy's offense moves the ball on the ground, and the way that we can't really stop the run, I would be lying if I said I wasn't at least concerned. We have the number one defense in the country, we have the number one run defense, but obviously, that's not really what we've seen the past couple of games. 30-plus points in back-to-back games after not allowing more than 10 for a very long stretch, or more than 9 for a very long stretch. We've got issues this week. We have to play a lot of 4-6, 4-3, 4-4 last season. I expect us to do the same, because obviously our corners and safeties can't get off blocks, and we need our linebackers out there making plays. But that, guys, will do it for this episode. Thank you for tuning in. See you guys next time. Have a nice day.